This is what happened when Katie Vines paid less than £5 for a phone charger.
I plugged it into my socket in my bedroom. I went off to the bathroom. My boyfriend was changing the baby at the time, and I heard a loud bang, and I went to see what it was, and unfortunately the phone charger had exploded into the socket.
When the first one went bang near her baby's cot, the online seller sent her another, but the same thing happened again.
I contacted the company and they sent me a replacement because I literally just thought it was a faulty plug. I didn't think that it would be an ongoing problem. And the owner of the company assured me that the next one would be fine. So I plugged it in downstairs and it exploded again.
More than 4 million counterfeit goods were seized in the UK last year, with mobile phone chargers now one of the top electrical fakes. Just under 10,000 phone accessories were taken in by trading standards, but it's suspected there are many more out there. Some have damaged gadgets, electrocuted people, and even caused fires. The Electrical Safety Council now want all of us to realise that by trying to save money, we could be taking a serious risk. But they fear the counterfeiters may get a boost, as some phone manufacturers are now thinking about selling handsets without chargers for environmental reasons.
It's very possible that there will be an increase, which is why we're working with the mobile phone operators and doing as much as we can to raise awareness of the situation to ensure that people aren't lured into purchasing substandard and counterfeit products.
Well, this is one of those websites where you can buy this kind of thing. Here you can get a car charger for £2.49. Now, while it may look the part and even charge your phone, there are no guarantees that it will definitely comply with those strict UK safety standards.
Apple is launching a type of amnesty, reducing the price of their chargers if you hand in a fake after a woman in China was electrocuted and died using one. I showed Bristol Trading Standards part of a charger I'd bought online for a few pounds.
I would say that you've probably gone for the cheap one and you've received a cheap product.
They're seeing more and more of this kind of thing, and being an international market, it's not easy to stop.
It is very frustrating for Trading Standards to see these on the market. It's worrying for us also. There is legislation that controls plugs and sockets, and that's there for a reason. It's there to protect the UK consumers and those that are in the EU.
With baby Amy only 10 months old, Katie is still watching what she spends, but now realises on some things it's just not worth taking that risk. Rhiannon Mills, Sky News in Bristol.